Hi! In this video, I'm going to talk about an introduction to iteration or repetition or loops. So far you've seen conditional statements. If something is true, do something else, do something else. So now we're going to talk about while something is true, keep on doing it. How long? Well, let's see. Iteration or repetition is an operation that causes looping. We want to keep repeating until a certain condition is true or false. Not just one time, but multiple times. Or maybe one time, but more than one time, most of the time. So here is a block of code. Here is our condition to test. If it is true, do something. Go back and check. So the syntax knows to go and check. That is the key. The syntax while knows to go back to the condition and check and keep doing it until that condition becomes false, at which point in time we do something else and we don't go back to the while loop. When the condition is false, we come out and continue with the rest of the program. So we have a condition to check, go one way or the other. Then we have what is called the body of the loop that actually performs something. The body of the loop must have an update for this condition. Otherwise, if this condition always remains whatever it was, we will never come out of the loop. So the body of the loop must have some statements that says update that condition. So let's take a look at a couple more things, and then in the next lesson, you will learn more about the different types of loops. So the computer repeats the code. The syntax or the iteration structure makes sure that the computer keeps repeating the code until a certain condition becomes false. So that is called a condition control loop. Or we can have count control loops. So the condition control loop checks for a condition. When that condition is true, the loop is executed. When that condition is false, the loop stops. A count control loop starts a counter, as the name indicates. It counts until it reaches a certain point. Could be forward or backward. It depends on how you write your count control loop. And it stops when the counter reaches the end. So condition control loop, true or false condition, count control loop, specific number of times. How many times do we want the loop to iterate? So then in the next lesson, you are going to learn about condition control loop and then about our count control loop. So I'll see you there.